music by American composer Amy Beach from the turn of the 20th century. She was exceptionally talented, could sing 40 songs by the time she was one. At two, she could sing counter melodies, wrote some piano waltzes by the time she was four. Exceptionally gifted. And that was the second movement from her piano concerto in C sharp minor, featuring Danny Driver and the BBC Scottish Symphony Orchestra. You're tuned to The Drive Home on Symphony 924, playing you only the finest music.
Anytime you need a friend, Symphony 924's Facebook page is all you need. Your companion 24/7. An instant connection to the world of classical music and your favorite symphony presenters. We'd love to hear from you. Drop by and say hi, or send us a request or dedication. We're at facebook.com/symphony924. Keep in touch. Enjoy the drive home. With all your classical favorites and more, Symphony 924.
Drive carefully. Drive carefully. Drive carefully. Drive carefully. Drive carefully. Drive carefully.
Stomitz, and Andreas Ottenshammer was accompanied by the Camera Academy Potsdam. It's time for the news update and 2 hours of the drive home right here on Symphony 94.
News from CNA.
Drive carefully.
Person for the justifier of the executions, saying they were done in the name of justice and the people, and that the military knew there would be criticism as global condemnation intensifies. Malaysia's foreign minister has become the latest to condemn the executions. Mr. Saifuddin Abdullah has called it a crime.
Drive carefully.
He says the military government should be banned from international ministerial level meetings, and that ASEAN should engage Myanmar's shadow government. Japan has confirmed its first case of monkeypox. A man in his 30s has tested positive for the virus and is currently in hospital. The Japanese government is holding emergency meetings in response to the country's first case of monkeypox virus. President Halima Yacob says she looks forward to working with new
Drive carefully.
To advance bilateral relations between the two countries. In a congratulatory letter, Madam Halima says President Mahmoud's resounding victory is testament to the people's confidence and respect towards her. Madam Halima